Hello, everybody. Ron here, DYB coach, also painting contractor up here in Northern Massachusetts. Why do I say that? A few people have commented. I have lived through what you're living through right now. I live it, breathe it every day. I'm also a coach, but I'm also a painting contractor. Have been for almost 18 years. In a couple weeks, it'll be 18 years. So I'm still practicing in the field. I don't actually swing a brush, but I lead some great teams, work with them every day, visit job sites and everything else. So anyways, that's why I just tell you that. Just want to explain why I keep saying that. So anyways, millennials, hiring and retaining them. We all know how hard it is to find new help, keep help. Seems like you gotta get someone good for a little while, and then all of a sudden they're saying, I'm sorry, I'm leaving. So we want to hire them, we want to retain them. A millennial, 19 to 34 year old person. So 19 to 34, my kids are all in that range, so I have all millennials. One out of three people working right now is a millennial. They're in the workforce. Millennials have now surpassed Gen X's and baby boomers in the workforce for population. So in the next 10 years, millennials will be 75% of our workforce. Good, bad, ugly, however you say it, you might be a millennial yourself. You might be hiring millennials. One of the reasons they're growing at such a rapid rate is immigration. However you feel about it, doesn't really matter. Population is here. Gen X's are also growing via immigration population, but the millennials are far surpassing everybody. So we learn to adapt, and maybe they can adapt a little to us, but I think we'll be doing most of the adapting as other generations have done for us. So what do millennials want? How do we retain them? Well, millennials want to work for a purpose for the company, a giving back, a underlying theme for the company. Millennials who have been pulled out there, and I've not only done the research, I've been with Sherwin-Williams and Benjamin Moore through their presentations and discussion groups about millennials, and everybody is now touching base on the same points. Millennials want to work for a purpose. They need underlying. They're not just here to make a buck and leave. Work the hours, take the check. There'll be some that want that, but most of them need a purpose. Purpose in our company is actually giving back. We do Paint It Forwards, which we provide either a charity, a person in need, a veteran. A few times a year, we have a poll out there. We ask for nominations. Once your nominations get in, our crews sit down and look at the nominations. Our crews decide who's going to get the Paint It Forward Day, and then we do this on a volunteer basis on a Saturday, a non-working day, when you involve the crew members, the team members, to give up their day off to help out. That's the underlying theme of our business, and this is how we can give back. Also, maybe give them the half day off to do a blood drive or something like that, or participating, and pay them for those hours. That's all part of overhead of a company. It's also taking care of your community. There's other ways to help out too, for community work, if that's what the millennials want in your area. So what are other things millennials are looking for? Obviously, technology. They are the latest and greatest technology. And we say, why? Well, they don't need it, they're painting. Well, there's so much technology in painting between our iPads, our iPhones, and whatever other technology you use. Our crew leaders have iPads. Our team members clock in and out on their phones using a program called T-Sheets. We'll talk about that in another video. So use it, adapt to it. There's so much out there. They've grown up with technology. They don't know what a wall phone is. They don't know what a voice recorder attached to the phone is. Everything has been in their hands. So, and they also want instant gratification. You know, you gotta think, they've always had a cell phone. They've never not had a cell phone. They get text, video on demand. They can watch a movie on their phone if they want. If they're at home, they don't turn the TV on. They open up their laptop or their iPad. They're used to having answers right now. They can Google anything for an answer. They don't open a yellow page. They don't even know what a yellow page is. So anyways, they need the technology with instant gratification. They're also looking for feedback. They want to know they've done a good job. You know, don't keep them in the dark. You might say, well, I pay them, I do with others. They're looking for instant feedback. This is proven things that help retain these millennials, the workforce that we all need. to be successful and to grow, if that's what you're looking at, or at least to maintain. As we know, we lose people by attrition all the time, and we got to keep the millennials. So technology, mentoring, we want to teach them. So let's have a few. So we want a technology. So you have tech. They want to be monitored. They want instant feedback. And they want to work for a purpose. So, you know, they're not terrible things. Really not terrible things to ask. Also, they want to be able to dress the way, you know, the interview and surveys and polls that were made weren't just for painting contractors. So some of these things might not hit the nail on the head for us. But they also don't want to dress in traditional dress. Painters whites, painters shirts. You're like, oh no, that's how we do it. You know, there's other ways to do this. There's khakis, there's colored shirts, there's things like that. So we're going to have to bend a little if we want to maintain and retain the next workforce. So, and they also want to be well paid. So as you see these right here, you got to see the well paid. You know, we all want to be well paid. So if you start them, you cherish them, you treat them like a great individual team member. So that's why they want some of these things. And we're asking ourselves, why does this all happen? They were brought in up in this environment. They were brought in the environment of instant technology. Everything is instantaneous. They've also had a lot of helicopter parents. Some of your parents out there aren't going to like this. But anyways, they have helicopter parents. You ever go to a kid's soccer game and the parents are yelling at the coaches? They're yelling at the refs? My kid's got to be the pitcher. Do you ever go to any of these, the basketball, any of these teams that the parents are always there? And the kids are always, kids with a 9-year-old kid with an iPhone in his hand. That's technology starting right away. They've also questioned authority. You know, well, we would never speak back, or most of us wouldn't speak back to authority, being teachers or parents or anything like that. They were brought up to question it. Their parents have questioned it and allowed them to question it. My son doesn't deserve an A on the test. You know, those are the things the teacher's not always right. When I grew up, the teacher was always right. So these are some of the things we're going to have to learn to adapt with. So as you remember, the 19 to 34-year-olds, you might like it or not, but they're there. So also, we want to keep open communication. They want open communication. They want be able to express themselves in speech. They want ever-changing latest technology. So we got to keep up with that. We just can't hand them a paintbrush. Maybe do a color app on their phone or something like that. You know, you got to be kind of forward thinking of that. And you want to embrace a higher level of company culture. One thing I did not talk about was they also look into flex time. Imagine that. They don't want to be at work at 7 to 3:30. They want to come in at 8 to 4:30. Maybe you could actually have a different crew, a second shift crew. You got to think outside the box. And I'm not thrilled with that outside the box kind of thinking, but you have to think differently if you want it to go. They also got to challenge them and set goals for them. They like to work for something. I talked about a purpose, but they also want to work to a goal. They just don't want to come to work, punch in, punch out, and go home. So anyways, these are some of the things that really hit the head on the hiring millennials of all the research we did. You'll see them once again right here. Some of the things you can think about is technology, instant gratification. I know we also talk to our crews with GroupMe, which is a free app on your phone. It's almost like a texting app, and they all can talk about it. We can also update everybody on that. For us, for technology, we use Basecamp to run all our projects. We let them punch in and punch out. The only way to punch in and punch out is on their phones using a program called T-Sheets. So those are some of the things that have worked great for us. And remember, as you're thinking about hiring for the upcoming months, think of your company's purpose. What's behind your company? And maybe how can you give back? That's a great way to start looking at things. Maybe you sit down during lunch or breakfast with your crew and ask them what really resonates with them. Maybe there's something that is a nice theme that's running through your company that you guys can jump on, bring it in as a team, volunteer to do it, be it on their time or your time. Embrace it, and you'll find that the culture of your team is elevated, and you'll also retain these employees as you need them. Anyways, I'm Ron Ramsey, and I'm a DYB coach, also a painting contractor up here in Mass. If you need to get in touch with me, it's ron@dybcoach.com. You can also send me a message on Facebook, as many of you have. Comment here in the comment line. Please subscribe to our YouTube channel. And if you want to hear more about DYB, you can just go to joindyb.com. So anyways, thanks for hanging out with me, and I'll see you on your next video. Bye.